Well, hello and welcome. You are joining me for this lesson called The Whole Note. Now, if you remember back from our previous lessons, we've already looked at the quarter note and we've looked at the half note. Now we're going to add the third and final note out of this lesson series. So let's take a closer look and see, what does the whole note look like? So here we have the whole note. Now, the whole note kind of looks like a circle, but it's a very important note, and the whole note gets four counts or four beats. So when you tap and say the whole note, you can either clap ta, which is for four counts, or you can say one, two, three, four. All right, try it with me. Hands up, we're going to count the whole note, and let's count the numbers. Ready, begin. One, two, three, four. Let's try it one more time. How many beats does the whole note get? If you said four, you are correct. Here we go. Ready, begin. One, two, three, four. Now, in the next part of the lesson, we're going to be drawing the whole note. Now, let's see, what does that look like? So, today we're going to look at the whole note, and I'm going to grab my highlighter here. And if you remember previously in the lesson, we were clapping the whole note. Now the whole note gets four counts or four beats. So if you can imagine four quarter notes, one, two, three, four, all of these quarter notes fit inside one whole note. Now, the first thing we're going to do is we're going to draw three whole notes. So if you have your pencil handy, go ahead and grab that. I'm going to grab my pencil here. And we're going to draw three whole notes, and then we're going to write one, two, three, and four below each note. Now, your whole notes don't have to be perfect, just try your best. So let's start with our first whole note, and let's draw the counts underneath, which are one, two, three, and four. Let's draw our second whole note like this. Again, it doesn't have to be perfect. Draw numbers one, two, three, and four. And finally, let's draw our last whole note. Counts one, two, three, and four. Now, the next thing we're going to do is we are going to make some markings on the notes that we're going to play. So let's look at problem number four, and I am going to begin by marking my dynamics. So if you have your colored pencils handy, let's grab our red pencil and we're going to highlight forte. Now, if you remember back from our previous lesson, forte means loud. Let's mark the other forte, also in red, which means loud. Now I'm going to go in and grab my blue pencil, and now we're going to mark the piano. That's a dynamic that means what? To play softly. So let's mark both of our pianos. Now the last thing we're going to do is we're going to highlight the different note values that we've learned. So I'm going to grab, let's grab a nice bright yellow. Now, if you remember back in our lesson about quarter notes, let's highlight our quarter notes just so we don't get confused. So we have four quarter notes in a row. You can highlight those. And then after our four quarter notes, we have some half notes. And let's choose a nice bright green, or you can choose a different color. Let's highlight our half notes. Now, if you remember, our half note gets how many counts? Two counts. So let's go ahead and go back and grab our pencil. So grab your regular pencil, and we're going to write the number of beats above each note just so we don't forget. So we're going to draw, or let's draw them below. Let's draw one, two, three, four, because that's our whole note, which gets four counts, followed by another whole note, which gets how many counts? Four counts, followed by four quarter notes, which get one count each. So we're going to count one, two, three, and four, followed by our two half notes. Now our half note gets two counts, so we're going to count one, two, and then for this final half note, we're going to put three, four. Now, even though I've written three and four, that doesn't mean it gets three counts and four counts. This means it gets two beats. So essentially, this is beat one and two. It's two counts again. So let's play together number four, the forte and piano rhythms. You're going to brace your third finger on high C. So first of all, find middle C, which is right in front of your belly button. We're going to play the next C up. So find that high C first and place your third finger supported by your thumb on that high C. Now we have two things to do in this exercise. We're going to be counting all of our notes, and we're also going to be adding our dynamics. Are you ready? Let's begin. One, two, ready, begin. One, two, three, four. Piano. One, two, three, four. Forte. One, two, three, four. One, two. Half note. So you've just completed your lesson, and I want to tell you, a job well done. Learning a new instrument is not easy. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to reach out. And if you'd like to share your music with me, that would be most exciting. All right, we'll see you at your next lesson.